Good morrow, everyone. Silvershire here, and welcome back to Hearthstone, where... Okay. Hello? Earth to Hearthstone? Okay.
Do 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 do. I just want to play Hearthstone. Why aren't you letting me do it? Why are you kicking me back out to the main frickin' menu?
Alright, I'm gonna go make a sandwich. Let me know when this loads. Check it out, brand new container. It's gonna be difficult one-handed. Look at that fresh peanut butter. Now, if you don't have time to make your own bread, store-bought is fine. Now, a very important step, wash off the knife, because you don't want peanut butter all up in your jelly. Now, much like the peanut butter, you want a real even coat of jelly on the other slice of bread. But depending on what kind of jelly you have, you might want to have less jelly than peanut butter, because jelly tends to have a bit of a stronger flavor. So now is the difficult part. And that, my friends, is how you make a peanut butter and jelly. Mmm, peanut buttery.
Well, yeah, that's because you stopped working. So just to recap, things that I've done in this Hearthstone video are sing the Jeopardy theme and do a cooking vlog. Things I have not done, play Hearthstone.
You gonna crash again? You're disconnected from your last game. I never got into a last game! Hearthstone. Hearthstone, you're killing me. Silvershire here, and welcome back to Hearthstone, where you apparently have to be very careful about saying anything political. And today, we are continuing to use the Enrage deck that I used in my last video. I think I might have swapped a card or two since then. I honestly don't remember. But this time, I'm going to try it out in Ranked, because needless to say, I've had some moderate luck with this deck. Definitely the best deck that I've made so far. That is not the best starting hand, though. Nothing I can play. Well, isn't that just peachy? I have a feeling that I'm going to do terrible, because that just seems to be how things go when I turn the... And there goes the heater to ruin my audio quality. Can nothing go right today? Alright, hopefully you guys can't hear any of that. Goodness. Happy Hollow's End! This is Hollow's End, this is Hollow's End! Let's do this. And that. I can worry about the token next turn. Assuming that he doesn't summon any taunt minions or just insta-kill me with spells or something, then I can use my Taskmaster to take out the totem, and I'll be able to deal another 6 damage to face. And all of that will be for no mana, so I could maybe even bring out another Dozing Marksman, an Armor Up, or something along those lines. Alright, so that's not gonna kill it. I wonder if he has a follow-up planned? Ah, alright, alright. Well, it's not terrible, I still got 6 damage right off the bat.
and I'll be able to take out his Murloc quite easily. I don't know if I want to bring out another Marksman without having a damaging card in my hand, but I don't really have any other minions I could play. Because this is kind of useless at the moment. That would be good if I have like a whole bunch of Enrage minions on the field or something, but I guess?
No.
I mean, I need to do that no matter what. Then I guess I'll just do this, because he has no minions, so hopefully I'll be able to start overwhelming him. Alright, what? Well, that was a high roll! After your opponent plays a minion, become a copy of it. Okay. So what do I want to turn that into? I don't have many options. I guess I could turn it into a Pyromancer and hope that just screws him up big time, because it doesn't really matter to me if he damages all of his minions. So I'm gonna do that, I think. Let's do that. He turns into him. I do that, I take out his healing totem, and now, if he wants to do any spells, he's either going to destroy his microbots, or he has to kill off his Pyromancer. Unless he has some sort of silence. I don't think... Does Standard Shaman have any silence? Actually, does Wild Shaman have any silence? I really don't know. It's almost one already. That stupid sandwich bit took so long. I mean, people seem to like the video where I ate a taco while I played Soul Calibur, so hopefully people will like my cooking vlog. I really try to hold on to my inner rage for as long as possible, because if you can get Grommash and Inner Rage, or Grommash, or I don't play World of Warcraft, so I don't know how things are pronounced, but if you can get the big green guy and then Inner Rage him, that is a 12 attack minion with charge for only 8 mana, which is pretty ridiculous. This is not an ideal situation, however. That. And then that. We'll get some armor out of it. Yeah, there's really no point in healing him because both of his minions are 5 attack. And I can't get him above 5 health, so. I guess I'm just gonna armor up, should I? Yeah, I might as well do this now. Hopefully that means I'll have a better next turn. Right, 2 Gurabashi Berserkers, that's good. I really would like to get some low-level minions that I can kind of just throw them at his taunt wall, but... Oh, no. Oh, no. Well, actually, I have Warpath, so that's not terrible to deal with. Can I board wipe him with Warpath? I'll have 8 mana, so that's 4 damage, so yeah, if I hit this guy, then I can wipe them all out with Warpath. So, I need to do 1 Warpath to get rid of... Right, this guy might survive. That was some serious lag. And then I do that. Alright, no, we're good. We're good. I thought I had messed up my math, but we're good. Because this will get rid of Taunt, but she still has 1 health left. so she can attack him. Then I can use my final boar path that is also going to wipe my board, unfortunately. But now I have a major health advantage and card advantage. And not a third advantage, but, you know, two's enough. I could... Do I want to go... Part of me really wants to bring out a Berserker and Enrage it and Rampage it. But I'm really scared that he is then going to instant kill it, and I will have wasted two of my best spells. And I'm scared that if I throw that out there raw, he's going to summon a Rush minion and just kill it. Well, I have two of them, so guess let's try it. If it survives to next turn, then I will do the Inner Rage Rampage combo. Combo, because I'm at least guaranteed one attack that way. Right, so he's just going face. Which I'm actually okay with for now. Oh, you want to summon a bunch of one health minions against this deck? Okay, if you insist. Oh, wow! So that was like I was acting all smug, and then Karma just decided to like step down and be like, "Oh, hey, Silvershire, how are you doing?" Wapow! There is nothing in my life that could possibly go wrong right about. Oh, that hurts. Gosh, yeah, this is...
What now?
This is not ideal. Well, that did not go well.
It's definitely the best deck that I've made so far.
Right, this is definitely a better starting hand. Oh, that's not super useful in the early, let me click on it. That's not super useful in the early game, so we'll see if I can get something better. Alright, that's good, because now I have a way to activate my Enrage minions. So, hopefully I'll be able to turn one Eternium Rover, turn two Armor Smith, get some armor built up. I did, the other day, I think I have a screenshot of it that I might put in the video, but I had two Eternium Rovers and an Armor Smith out, and then I played Warpath to just build up so much armor. It was great. And my enemy had a whole bunch of low health minions, so I was able to clear the board in addition to getting like so much armor. It was great. Loot Porter. Alright. Gotta continue as planned. If I do this, they'll clear the board, get me a nice bit of armor. I don't know why I turned Italian. It's gonna get me a nice bit of armor. I'm so sorry to all Italians. I've just offended an entire country. Let's do this. This, and then that. I have three minions on the field, one of them is buffed, I have five armor. Things are looking pretty good, and then that happened, but I'm still gonna get some armor out of that. And now I have the cards in my hand necessary to set up some sort of dozing marksman combo. That's eight armor, that's great. All right, that's a good card to have, can't play it just yet. Yeah, I don't want to bother with the Frightened Flunky yet, because he doesn't have any minions that I am scared of hitting me directly. So I'm just going to do that and that. Next turn, I can hit the Marksman with Inner Rage. That'll beef him up nicely. And then I could also summon the Flunky, depending on what he summons. Alright, just another Loot Hoarder. I ain't as scared of that. Right, Gurubashi Berserker. That's good. Do I wanna... Because if I do Inner Rage the Dozing Marksman, then he would be able to kill it immediately. Oh, well, I have the taunt minion, so let's do that. Get him to 6 attack and attack directly. And now if I bring out the frightened flunky, that should protect him on the next. Oh, this is so good. Need to save it for the late game, but that's a really good card. And then I could bring out the Spellzerker, but I don't really have a reason to, so I'm gonna armor up. I'll also need to use my coin sometime soon, because one of my biggest problems in this game is that I hold on to the coin for way too long, and then it ends up becoming useless. Although the coin could be useful in the late game to set up some sort of Grommish combo. I'm so not pronouncing that right. Grommish sounds like an old English man. Mr. Grommish! Alright, that takes care of the marksman, which is unfortunate, but I was still able to get 6 attack off, and I still have a lot of armor, and all he has is a couple of Silverhand recruits. Alright, I don't want to bring this guy out yet. I would get quite a bit of value out of the security rover, considering how few minions he has. And then if he doesn't attack it, then next turn I can damage it on purpose to get a taunt minion out, so that then I can summon the Gurabashi Berserker and not worry about him insta-killing it. Is that a good by the holy light or a bad by the holy light? I have a feeling that's a bad by the holy light. I have a feeling that's I just got an awesome card by the holy light. Let me think. Now, I could probably get rid of the Spellzerker in this deck, because she definitely has her uses, but she's a pretty situational card. I wonder if it would be better to just have some more taunt or some more armor in this deck. Alright, Eternium Rover is good. I could really do with my AoE damaging cards. I haven't gotten any of those this game, because that would just rack all his Silverhand recruits. Guess let's do that and that. Bro, I'm gonna justice, I don't know, insert witty comeback here. I'm gonna do that, and then I'll do that to bring a taunt minion out. And then I'll do this and that, just because I can, and because at this point in the game, I really shouldn't need a coin to bring anything out, because Grommish is my highest damaging card, or my highest cost card, sorry. He's my highest cost card, and he is only 8. Man, please give me a Warpath, because I could just annihilate him with a Warpath. Or even Whirlwind, because most of his minions are only at 1 health. Could probably pick off the stragglers after a Whirlwind. Alright, strange that he's... Okay, I would have put that on a minion that had more than 1 health myself, but... Another dozing monk. Why? Where are my spells? I've not gotten any spells this game, other than that one inner rage right at the beginning. I might want to just damage all my characters and then do a battle rage and see what happens. Yeah, I guess let's do that. And then I'll sacrifice him. And then I could only attack him, which I don't really want to do, because I want to keep my taunt minion. All And then I can do that and armor up. And next turn, hopefully she will have some damage. And then I can battle rage to draw some cards and wipe out his silver hand recruits. Oh, that's not good for me. Alright, I might stand to regret this strategy, but we'll see what happens. Oof. That's not great. He's giving the banana to that recruit. Aw, man. I'll have 9 mana next turn, though. Please, Warpath. Please, Warpath. Not at all what I needed. That sucks. I mean, I really don't want to bring him out yet because I'm at full health, but I don't have much else I can do. Guess I can just do that and that and end my turn. I think I've already lost this game also. I have such good luck when the camera's off, and then I turn the camera on, and I just start to suck. When the camera's off, I have good luck. When the camera's on, I start to suck. It's gonna be the theme song for this video. He didn't get through my- Why? Why? Where are my spells? That was not necessary. That was overkill.
Definitely the best deck that I've made so far.
This really should be, like, the cheeriest game that I play. It's a card game. It's a card game where there's, like, fancy little loot music in the background and, like, Murlocs going, wah! And yet this fills me with more salt than the games where people are shooting at me. I don't get it. Right, going up against Lobster. Alright, all awful cards to have in my starting hand. RNG, please treat me better than you did last game. Alright, I can do something with this, which knowing my luck will be totally shut down by whatever trap he just played. Do that. And then that.
Definitely the best deck.
I'm coming up with 32.33, repeating, of course, percentage of them liking the video.
It's a lot better than we usually do. Alright, do you think they subscribed?
Oh my god, he just clicked on the video.
You gotta subscribe first, man!
So now is the difficult part.